All right, today is part two, test and tune day. You have to excuse my rigging here. This is just to hold it up temporarily to my vertical pole here. That's the Gap Titan DX vertical. That's what I usually talk off of. That's what I always talk off of, because that's all I got right now. But now I have this KM4ACK in-fed half-wave antenna. As you see, I got the wire running out up into and over the little tree limb, about maybe 6-7 feet in there. And then it goes to that white pole and it's sticking out of the ground. So the whole thing may be a max of 5 feet off the ground. Just trying it out, that's all it is. So here, see the other side of it with the toroid and the connector. Now I had this all covered up with hot glue, but let me tell you what happened. I got out here and I hooked it up and couldn't hear nothing receiving. So I put a camera on the inside of the shack with audio looking at my radio and come out here and pulled it up on my phone and got to messing with it and realized if I take the sleeve of the 259 off the 239 and just left the center pin, it received great. So I had something amiss. I ended up taking it back inside. I couldn't figure it out. And I had, like I said, I had all that covered with hot glue to keep it steady, whatnot. When I took it out, I realized that my magnet wire here had slipped out, I guess, of the center pin while I was soldering and was just hanging off to the side of the center pin. It appeared under the hot glue that it was connected, but it was not. So we went back in, of course, made a little bit more of a sloppy mess with my soldering, but it works, okay? It works. I'm not getting paid to do this. And so anyway, we got that ran out through there. Excuse the yard. I had this tree cut down and haven't cleaned all of it up yet. It's been too rainy and muddy to get here. As you can see, it's a low spot. So anyway, I almost got snake bit coming out here, no joke. The sun gun striked at me. It was just a little blue racer, so he went on the other way. So let's go see how this thing works.
Echo 8, Oscar.
All right, let's see. Here's a 40 meter. Kilo November 4, Oscar Kilo, in a park over in Alabama.
Roger, roger, Kilo Echo 8, Oscar.
See, he's pretty strong there. That's 9 on the meter. You'll see I do not have the tuner turned on. That would be the tuner. So tuner's off, and then down here you'll notice SWR. Kilo 5, Yankee, Victor, Yankee. Yeah, you got it. Kilo 5, Yankee, Victor, Yankee. Name here is Joe. In Mississippi, Mike Sierra. Sounding great. You're an S9 and 5-9 as well.
Roger, roger. Thanks for the 5-9, Mississippi. Yeah, sounding great here too, North Alabama. Thank you very much. 73s.
73, have fun.
Thank you. QRZ, Parks on the Air.
November 9er, Delta Papa Romeo.
There you go.
Bravo, Steve.
Yeah, it worked one state over. Pretty good.
Mike, was that, or
and that's a power setting at 35% 7300, so
yeah,
you know,
November
50 or less
Delta
antennas
Papa
ready for 50, so.
Roger, roger.
And close to contact. QRZ, Victor Alpha 3, Triple 8, VA 3, AAA calling, say Q and is standing by for any possible call.
Kilo 5, Yankee, Victor, Yankee.
Kilo 5, Yankee, Victor, Yankee, 5 and 7, Ontario, Canada, name Stanley, secure modulation, my friend, over.
QSL Stanley, thank you. The name is Joe, Juliet Oscar Echo. You're a 5656 into Mississippi, Mike Sierra, go ahead.
Yeah, okay, Joe in Mississippi, excellent, and thank you for the 5 and 6, eh? Lots of QSB, Joe, so I don't want to make it too long. But I appreciate the shout from Mike Radio. Stay safe until the next time. Enjoy the Alpha 3 AAA. Thanks again. Stay safe.
Yeah, 73. Have fun.
Say
there's Canada on 20 meters.
Alpha 3, Alpha, 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 Stanley Island.
I don't see any stations on the cluster, and not really seeing any on the scope. So we'll go ahead and just do a call out of my call sign so you can see the SWR here on 15 meters with no tuner and at 35% power. This is Kilo 5 Yankee Victor Yankee K5YVY. As you see, it stayed below 1.5. So, pretty good.
Okay, bye-bye. Good day.
Where is it?
Kilo 5 Yankee Victor Yankee.
CQZX, Papa Yankee 2, Florida Zulu, Papa Yankee 2, Foxtrot Zulu, CQ, CQZX, Papa Yellow 2, Florida Zulu, calling ZX, stand by.
Kilo 5, Yankee, Victor Yankee.
CQ, CQZX, CQ Delta XA, Alonso.
Let's try the tuner.
CQ, CQZX, Yankee 2, Florida Zulu. Papa Yankee 2, Foxtrot Zulu, CQ, CQDX, Papa Yellow 2, Florida Zulu, calling DX, stand by.
Kilo 5, Yankee, Victor Yankee.
CQ, CQDX, CQ Delta.
Anyway, you see how quiet it is, anyway.
CQDX, Papa Yankee 2, Florida Zulu.
Tell the neighbors noise or whatever that is, kick it on. You see that contact I just made? That was about 10 watt to KD9GY, 560 miles away. He gave me a plus, no, I gave him a plus 23. And he gave me a plus 1. And I'm running 10 watts. So that's all right. Look at PSK Reporter. Sure, I don't have an answer to my call. All right, yeah, we look over at PSK Reporter. Getting hurt in the States. Look at that. My antenna right now is pointed toward the east. No, pointing toward the west, so it's west-east. Oh, and he gives me a minus 5 when I give him a plus 15. That's okay, because I'm running like 10 watts. Let's see. There we go. All right. You see the power there? Not very much. 2 bars. Let's set to 10%. Looks like I'm still just stateside, because that was on 40 meters. I'm going to change this over to 20. I'm going to try some FT4. Kilo 5, Lima Delta. Got him coming back. Got me at a negative 3. I mean, that's not too bad. I'm just running 10 watts on a infed half wave 5 feet off the ground. Let's take a look at the PSK reporter on my FT4, and I was heard a little bit further up into Canada a little. Being heard to the west coast now. Still stateside in 20 meters, but did get heard in Mexico. All right, this has been my videos on the KM4ACK infed half-wave antenna. I'm really glad I've got this antenna. It's really going to open the world for me on doing portable operations. And now I've got something where I can actually go with POTA and try some of that. Might get with Steve Goodgame, K5ATA. He lives county next to me. Get with him, let him show me how to do some POTA activations. And I just look forward to it. I've always only had homemade dipoles and stuff, and some of them wasn't very efficient. You know, anything from just stranded wire to old electrical extension cables. And although that's fine, you know, I didn't really know what I was doing. And this is the first antenna that I've had that had a 49-to-1 for sure, any kind of ballon. I've never had an antenna with a ballon, if that, you know, besides an ugly ballon where you air wind it. But so it's really opened my eyes to the possibilities, and I'm glad I got this antenna, and I'm afraid it may make me want to buy some more. Hey, but that's how radio goes, right? So anyway, in ending, I just want to share, you know, this come with the antenna. And you can't really see it because of the light, but here I just made a note, 40 through 10. That's what the antenna is rated for, is 40 meters through 10 meters. So I'll keep this in my bag just to remind myself when I go to use it. Okay, this is the, I say 40 through 10, but it's actually 40, 20, 15, and 10 meters. So you got four bands that this antenna is efficient on. And I took some SWR readings as well. And just for reference, I wrote it on the back, so I could see later on and compare it if anything changes. But just to share with you, on 40 meters, I got the antenna down to a 1.2, as well as on 20 meters, a 1.2. 15 meters is 1.3, and 10 meters in the 28 megahertz section, the sideband portion of the band, is a 1.8. Well, it's just a little bit higher, but in the 29 megahertz range, the FM portion was a 1.0. Now, I'd like to mention as well, the 1.8 is perfectly fine on the 10 meter sideband because the antenna is rated for a 2 or less SWR across these four bands. So it's within its capabilities as stated. Now, for fun, I said, let's see what these other bands do. You know, you always want to see what the other bands do. So I tested 12 meters and it was a 2.3 SWR. 17 meters was a 3.1, 80 meters was a 6.7, 160 meters, 5.5. And then this is interesting. I'm going to have to see how well I can hit some repeaters or something. 2 meter FM was 1.7 and 440 megahertz was a 2.0. I'm sure it won't radiate as efficiently, especially horizontally, but that's what it is. I just wanted to know. You always got to test that out. Thank you for watching and appreciate it. Make sure you subscribe to the channel and click the bell for notifications, because I have no schedule on when I might put out a video or go live, and I hate for you to miss that. So appreciate it. Oh. And bye. Well, there you go. There's my video of the take with me. So we're looking.